Oferecimento Torcida, o salgadinho da torcida brasileira. Qualidade look. Meus minutos telefônica. Você deu a ideia.
And I think he was literally stunned himself by the audience reaction to this. And suddenly discovered, well, yeah, I mean, it's all working. It's not going to be the disaster.
está apresentando Fim de Noite.
Jogue a cópia da chave.
Você ainda não está pronta.
E teu tambor.
Não pode ser assim, cara.
Quando eu digo que não devo te amar.
Você está imitando alguém.
Você acha que alguém que canta no chuveiro pode vir aqui nos convencer e se tornar um ídolo?
Eu sei que vou te amar.
Você conseguiu, rapaz?
Ídolos, a voz de uma nova estrela. Em breve, aqui no SBT.
Essa é a tua chance. Tem 30 segundos para nos convencer.
Concert, do they have an influence in your music?
No. Maybe it is. I don't know.
And do you think that the piano has enough keys, 88, or do you want more or less?
I mean, it's hard work to play those 88s.
I was in the room, Nellie was in the room, backstage, and the reporter came in and asked him what kind of music he liked. And Thelonious, well, like all kinds of music, a pretty legitimate answer. And then the reporter said, well, do you like country music? Thelonious didn't answer. And the reporter said, well, do you like country music? And Thelonious didn't look at the reporter, looked at me and said, I think this fellow's hard of hearing.
Thank you. Tell his friend you. Hey, I got a present to you.
$1 million?
No. Not quite. Here. It's a marker, you know? No, it's a...
Yeah, but see, I don't like to carry a pen on me, but sometimes it's that old girl. Sometimes I haven't got the pen, you know?
But this one
so is the energy.
Just like
a moment. Oh, is that jive or
no,
all for real?
No.
What, is it silver?
It's silver, but try the marker. It's like a magic marker. Well, that's not much
for the paper.
You see?
Set my mouth wide open.
Here's a proper piece of paper.
Proper piece of paper. So I do it etiquettely. Can you read that?
A beautiful message.
Because somebody can decipher that for you, you know, and say what it means, and dig what it means. You know? Obsession. Right. You'll flip. I mean, flip for real. You know?
Just in time for his first overseas concert. And I went backstage afterwards, and Mary Lou Williams introduced me to him. That's how I met him. But we hung out for the rest of the time he was there, and he had a ball. He was there about a week. Then I came back to New York a couple of months later. I was then living in the Stanhope. And, you know, like all the musicians used to come up there, but after Bird died there, they threw me out.
You much.
So then I went to the Bolivar, and that's when I got my piano. Polonius and I got together. That's where he wrote Brilliant Corners, Bolivar, Belize, I believe. At night, we'd go out round the clubs, and then all musicians would come back with us to the Bolivar, and we'd have these fantastic jam sessions until 8 or 9 the next morning. So, of course, eventually, that caused trouble, and I was thrown out of there. And we decided it was time I should get a house of my own. And I got this house, which was known at first by Thelonious as Catfish.
Estamos apresentando Fim de Noite. Se você joga pôquer ou quer aprender a jogar, veja o torneio mundial de pôquer aos domingos no SBT. Os melhores jogadores de...
little tune I just composed not so long ago, entitled Pannonica. It was named after this beautiful lady here. I think her father gave her that name after a butterfly that he tried to catch. I don't think he caught the butterfly. But anyway, here's the number I composed named after her, Pannonica.
G flat. fourth birthday cake, please.
What you want me to hear? Because I just, what I did, I just wrote. You want me at the top notes? I just wrote those two. What you want me to hit here? You want me to hit C on my notes, the concert. I was going to see. What you want me to top notes?
Any notes you want there.
Any notes I want there?
No, just any,
you know,
just here. Yeah,
right.
Any one of them.
Yeah, but, well, I can get right. I can get D and C then, huh? I hit this note here, C. But right here is two notes here. It's either C sharp or C natural.
Yeah.
What? One of those.
Yeah.
Now hold on scale there. A hold on scale there. Then an A flat 7.
Oh,
an A flat
okay.
7.
I.
And is and E is in D flat. You does something like that. You does something like that. You does something like that. Just before, prior leaving, he was right into it, you know.
I never would think, thought that he would stop all of a sudden and don't play. But something happened, something really clicked in him there. He didn't want to play anymore. Because I know I've asked him a couple of times. He never gave me any reason. See, I just don't feel like playing no more.
Whatever ailed him just overwhelmed him, and he just withdrew. I don't think it was an anger or a, you know, about music. I think it had nothing to do with music. It had to do with him and his energy and his outlook and his life, and that had nothing to do with music. Nothing. You know, like, I haven't got it anymore. I know it. I know it wasn't there. I'm not in his brain, but I know that couldn't have been what it was.
We were driving home from New York. This was the first year he lived here, 1972. And he suddenly turned to me and said, "I'm very seriously ill." This is the only thing Polonius has ever been heard to say about being ill at all. He never said it again.
Thank you. Azia.